facilitate thinking. I engage minds. I listen to questions. I encourage risk. I support struggle. I cultivate dreams. I learn every day. With these teaching philosophy, I welcome you all for the one-day workshop on the statement of teaching philosophy to support teacher autonomy. We are joined by eminent leaders who constantly motivate, guide, and propel us through the right path. They are none other than our Honorable Deputy Commissioner in absentia and Assistant Commissioners. We also have a learned resource person, Srinivasan Sir, from ZEd Mumbai. We shall start the program by invoking the blessings of the Almighty. All of us are aware of the National Education Policy, where the teachers are given freedom to teach in their own way, and this have put in the statement, that is statement of teaching philosophy. So this workshop is being organized by KVS. It is a privilege that we have been chosen to be part of this program, which empowers us to be better teachers. To continue with the program, we know that Vasudeva Kutumbakam, which means we are one family. Yes, we all belong to the KV family, which gives us ample opportunities to nurture our dreams and mold our abilities. This is one such platform. I request our Honorable Assistant Commissioner, Shri P.C. Raju Sir, for the welcome address. Sir, please.
Thank you, Madam. So indeed, it's my great privilege and honor to welcome the distinguished personalities of this program. Dear teachers, I take this opportunity to welcome the senior most assistant commissioner of Bangalore region, who is expertise in this field, especially in the field of philosophy. So with us, our assistant commissioner, Dr. Narasimham sir, is with us. It's my proud privilege and honor to welcome our honorable assistant commissioner, Sri Narasimham sir, for this one-day workshop on statement of philosophy. And also, I take this opportunity to welcome the resource person from JIT Mumbai. Actually, the statement of teaching philosophy, we all the assistant commissioners were trained from this JIT office. So now we are lucky to have the resource person, Mr. Srinivasulu, is with us. So he will be having a wonderful sessions and he'll be interacting with all the participants. And definitely participants will be enriched and he will be gained a lot through Mr. Srinivasulu. I also take this opportunity to welcome Srinivasulu sir for this one-day workshop. I take the opportunity to welcome my colleague, Madam Bhanumati, who has entrusted for organizing this workshop with her team of teachers. So welcome you, Madam Bhanumati, for this one-day workshop. You see, we are all familiar with this National Education Policy 2020. For implementation of this 2020 National Education Policy, so we are equipped, we are rigorously trained in this field. Even last week, almost all the assistant commissioners, we were trained in phonics workshop. Prior to that, the statement of teaching philosophy. Now in turn, so we will be training all the teachers so that in turn, so while implementing this national policy on education in your teaching learning process, it will be much more beneficial to you teachers. You see, even though because of this COVID-19, I can say all the teachers who are taking part in this video conference, I can say it's, we are lucky to have these conferences like this. You see, earlier we used to go to the training centers, might be JDITs or some other schools, all the way traveling, and we used to involve in these training programs and then come back and we used to implement in our school programs. So by the blessings of COVID-19, so we could able to stay in our respective schools, sometimes at your home, sometimes switching off your video you cannot attend. So many more advantages with this video conference. But dear teachers, I can tell you, I can assure you, so definitely, so you will be having a wonderful time and you will be learning many more things through this one-day workshop on teaching philosophy to support teacher autonomy. Once again, I take this opportunity to welcome all the participants for this one-day workshop. And in today, so we will be learning many more things by interacting with each other. And in turn, so we will be supporting to our children. Once again, so I, in absence of my Honorable Deputy Commissioner, Sri Sirimala Sambanna sir, I take this opportunity to welcome the Senior Most Assistant Commissioner, Dr. Narasimham sir, Madam Bhanumati, Srinivasulu sir, and all the other participants for this one-day workshop. Thank you, participants. Thank you, Vananda. Thank now you, it's sir. Over to Lekha.
Thank yes, you, sir, for a warm welcome. As teachers, we have the opportunity to foster positive changes to the everyday experiences in our schools. With this workshop framework, we are creating a community of learners and educators who will work together to help each other grow in their thinking and become better educators. To brief us on the one-day workshop and for the keynote address, I call upon our Honorable Assistant Commissioner, Sri A. G. A. Narasimhan, sir. Sir, please.
Am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good morning to all of you.
Good morning.
Respected Raju, sir.
Good morning, sir.
I am really very fortunate for giving me this opportunity. I am very much interested in all academic programs because learning is a continuous process. There is no full stop. It is only a comma. So wherever any academic programs are there, by interacting with all of you, by talking to all of you, I always feel pleasure. So for this, I am extremely grateful to Raju sir for giving me this opportunity. I'm also madam, for timely sharing the link. And here, one important thing to all of you, Mr. Srinivasan was my PGT. When I was the principal at Kendriya Vidyalaya Guntur, he was my PGT at KV Guntur. And afterwards, when I came to Mumbai, he is presently working in Mumbai as a training associate. And we both are staying in the same building. He is almost my neighbor. His son, Hari, is my best friend also. So now I'm very happy that the person who worked as a PGT with me is now one of the trainers. So it is a God-given gift. Now, I would like to, as per the statement of teaching philosophy, the complete guidance and the other things Mr. Srinivasan will give. Before I start my talk, I would like to tell all of you the second wave of corona is very severe. Now, things are very not a very good way. So first of all of you, I sincerely advise all of you take utmost precautions where wearing mask, maintaining social distance, cleaning your hands. Because if all of you are disturbed, you cannot contribute for the organization and for your family also. So in this context, all of you, I pray God that all your school staff, principal, everybody, your family members should have a good health. So don't be very careless, very careful and extra careful for maintaining your good health by taking all precautions. Now, as for that statement of teaching of philosophy, it is concerned in the new education policy. The new education policy is talking mainly on the teacher empowerment and enrichment program. As far as possible, teachers should be given freedom, the teacher autonomy, in choosing the methodology so that the teaching learning will be effective. As you know very well, from 2016-17, back to basics, our Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan has taken place. The idea of back to basic is whatever, and afterwards, you know, the NCRT started learning outcomes. As a follow-up, CBSE also has taken learning outcomes. And now PISA has come, program of international student assessment. So, and next, critical and creative thinking, all these things really convey to you is what is happening. Simply, our main aim is all the children from class 1 to 8, the parents and children, they are taking very lightly because we know very well we pass in the exam. And 10th class only limited content and simply rote memorization, passing examination. The new education policy 2020 says, because the objective of new education policy is to train the children to achieve the desired learning outcomes. And these students, when they come to the life, they should be able to confidently face the real life situations. That is a student development. And here, you know the constitutional values, ethics, concern, personal hygiene, nutrition, physical fitness, and ethics, punctuality, courtesy. So actually, in 1986, when Mr. Rajiv Gandhi was the Prime Minister, the new education policy came first in 1968 and afterwards 1986. 1986, it is talking about access and equity. That means all the children should be enrolled. And equity means involving all the children, disabilities, and irrespective of the caste, creed, color, and their income and family background. Now, the present 2020 new education policy, if you see, there are five objectives: access, equity, and quality. Most important thing is quality education. So actually, the quality education will be achieved only by having the effective teaching learning environment. So here, the idea of introducing you, as and when I am getting any paper cuttings or any circulars from KVS headquarters, in all the groups we are posting, we are informing your principals also. Please take a printout and file it and read. And especially our secretary of school education, Madam Anita Karwal, she has published one article, Joy of Learning. And our director of academics, CBSE, Mr. Emmanuel sir, There are a number of circulars. Please regularly log on to CBSE academic website. Now, idea of as a outcome of this new education policy, what has come out is competency-based education, achievement of learning outcomes. That means when a child coming out, and another thing here, interdisciplinary approach. That means one subject should be correlate to other subjects. And here you can see in your class 10th and other classes also, in each subject, you are supposed to do, the child is supposed to do one project that is art integrated project. And specifically in the EBSB, we have a state that is Uttarakhand. So specifically in the subject like social studies, the students of Karnataka, they are supposed to do selected project related to the Uttarakhand. The idea is what universalization of education, and there are many things they have spoken in the new education policy. But as far as today's thing is concerned, those things only I will talk. The most important thing is I told you quality. To achieve quality education, they have observed many students up to class 8 or primary section, they are not able to read, they are not able to write, they are not able to do the minimum counting, multiplication, addition, subtraction, division, and LCM, HEF. So after doing so much of spending a lot of money in education, and so many qualified teachers, I'm talking about Kendri Vidyalaya Sangathan, I'm not talking about state government. And as far as our working conditions, our infrastructure, our quality of teachers, what is the main concern here is methodology, that is pedagogy. There is a book published by CBSE, Pedagogical Leadership. Actually, with the correlation of National Institute of Planning and Administration, Madam Maithili, he was the writer of the author of the book, this actually, Madam Anita Kadwal and Mr. Manoj Gupta, Secretary CBSE, continuously they are in contact with so many educational organizations, and they have published a book. If you see the CBSE academic website, there is a book called 21st Century Skill, Handbook for Teachers, Handbook for Students, Handbook for Principals. It is mandatory, you can inform your principal, one copy or two copies of hard copy should be available in the library, and even every teacher also you have to keep experiential learning. Here, I can tell you experiential learning means there are some clever people, they say suppose a live electric wire. So I want to learn electric, the experience learning, I will go and touch. That is not experience learning. If you are going to touch electric wire, you will die. Experiential learning means the people, those who are eminent in the field of education or in any household, our parents, out of their struggle in various things, they have gained some experience, and those experiences they are passing on to us, learning by doing. Because it is not for cutting jokes. There are so many efforts have been made for last four or five, starting from 2014. And Mr. Prakash Javadekar was the chief minister of HRD, and afterwards Madam Smriti Irani, now this Ramesh Pokhriyalji, and the Kasturi Rangan, or many other members, they struggled. There are so many meetings. And you can understand, last year, because of COVID, all the government offices, because of lockdown. But even then, the Central Board of Secondary Education, NCERT, they struggled a lot. A number of books they published. Our main concern is even the migrant laborers, even the downtrodden sections, socially, economically disadvantaged groups, and poorer sections, everybody, the quality of education should reach, and the nation's progress and prosperity is very important. So the foundation of literacy and numeracy. So this concept in everybody's blood, in all teachers, actually as per the new education policy, even now or from the beginning, you can see the Gurukul also, the influenced teacher, the inspired teacher, the mentor of the teacher, actually nobody can substitute a teacher. We are facing so many hardships. Actually, face-to-face interaction, learning from the teacher, that is more important. But now the situation is very critical. Now the entire field of education, any development in the education, is solely depends on the teacher. That is why I respect a lot of teachers. Your health, your peace, your mind, it is very important. Do not work like a machine. Think. And we want live. We want a satellite telecast, not a recorded tape recorder. It should not be like a recorded cassette. And the objective of education is to make the child very strong and the nation should prosper. Small countries, you can see, they are showing a lot of... Now the idea is the child should learn less, but more output is should be there. It is joyful learning, discovery-based learning, inquiry-based learning, and problem-solving, critical thinking, improving communication skills, collaboration, and what is that, experiential learning, and another thing, technological development. And now, you see, Deeksha portal is there. Vidyadan, so many things have come. Alternative academic calendar. There is a circular about alternative academic calendar and competency. It is circular number 34. Actually, I want to tell you, all of you are addicted for this WhatsApp and Facebook and other things. I want that you please addict yourself to CBSE academic website. The number of circulars frequently they are coming regarding learning outcomes, pedagogical leadership, and Vidyadan. Another thing, as per the new education policy, skill development. You can see also our Prime Minister also very frequently talks about digital learning and skill development. That means many people are they are studying, producing marks. They can't speak a single sentence, and the quality of the diploma holders of electrical engineering. Or they are not able to just identify how the electrical equipments are functioning. That means our aim is only to get the marks and pass in the examination. So that is not the objective of new education policy. New education policy specifically talk about skill development, vocational education in this academic year in every region. Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan asked to identify 8 schools. In our region also, we have developed 8 schools. One is Jalahalli number 1, I remember. Another is Hubballi number 1. And main pace setting school is Kendriya Vidyalaya MEG Center, which is really near to regional office. So first, an experimental basis, things will start in KV MEG. So main thing is vocational education. So once, that means what is everything output oriented. They have studied something. I will tell you, there are some parents, they used to consult me during lockdown. Sir, what our children learn? I see, stitching a button, cooking, and what is that, gardening. There are so many, and fitness. There are so many things you can do at home. See, where there is a will, there is a way. Because you cannot say that corona, you go, means it will not go. So you have to accept adjustability, adaptability to the situation. And your self-motivation, your inspired teaching, your way of thinking, your devotion, dedication, all these things are very important. So who is the most important person in the field education? He is the teacher. So though I became assistant commissioner, but I always feel that I am also a teacher. So this learning is a continuous process. So another thing, the new education policy is talking about method of teaching. That means you have to create interest in the subject what you are teaching. The child should be able to learn, and he should, just like Dronacharya, how Ekalavya prayed Dronacharya, in the absence of Dronacharya, simply by keeping one statue, he became a student. So even if you are one day, your class is not there, there should be a wonderful one-to-one correspondence between you and your child. And because of your way of teaching, the child should feel that whenever we go for an inspection, we call what are your difficult subjects, what are your easy subjects. I can say wonderfully, there are many children, they are talking their interesting subject is mathematics and science. One of the reasons that the entire society is taking that mathematics is only important, science is only important. That is not correct, my dear children. Every subject is equally important. All subjects should be given equal importance. If you do not know how to speak, before 35 years or 36 years, I was born and brought up in a Telugu place, and I do not know how to talk English. I do not know how to talk Hindi also. I struggled. I have seen many of the Hindi films. I have seen English news. Even now also, whenever I find time, I will be listening to the news. speaking, reading, writing, listening, comprehension. And another thing, this is primary. I request all the teachers, those who are teaching class 1 to 8, please do not think there is no examination, no teaching learning will take place. Whether you are a contractual teacher, even if you are a miscellaneous teacher also, the most important thing in the school education is organizing and maintaining the arrangement periods. When I was a principal, maximum time I used to spend in the classes, especially the subject where the children are not able to understand. And punishment, fault finding, these things will not give you solution. The only solution is everyone, you have to introspect yourself. How far I am able to do justice. After speaking 1 hour or so, at least if I take a feedback, my dear friends, whatever I spoke, how far it is reached to you. So another thing, what I want to talk to you is, in this cluster system, in Kendriya Vidyalayas, we are already having. So you have to interact with your neighboring teachers. And I would like to give you suggestion. No, though suggestion in the present situation, it may not be possible. But even then, when you are taking Google Meet, one teacher's class, another teacher has to attend. If one teacher is doing very well, please try to do it. Do not have ego. One day you will go, I will go. Why you go? This ego will destroy you. Especially in the academic leadership, as a teacher, as a principal, as an administrator, our main concern is the children and how to educate the children, how to make them competent, how to develop skills, how to develop abilities. And all these things are very important. This is what a new education policy says also. Their language skills. Here, though they say their mother tongue, but Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangatam is a specialty school. Here, as far as the Karnataka is concerned, there is a demand from the parents that they want to learn Kannada. So once the main stream of school function, because in online, I think German and Kannada, we are not introducing. But once the school function, as per the request, because in state government, if you are, their children are not studying Kannada, they will not get state government jobs. That is why, as a special part of education, we are encouraging them to learn. But otherwise, our main is English and Hindi. Hindi is our national language and English international language. And we have conducted a phonics workshop. And first of all, when I was a principal, and even when I was educated, the Western Commission, Mumbai region, whatever schools I attached, many times I told, you would divide the entire day into two equal parts. And first, in the morning, all of you should speak English. In the afternoon, after lunch break, all of you should speak in. You have to interact in mother tongue only after the long bell is given. During the school time, whoever speaks, you have to speak in English and Hindi only. You can see small children, when they're watching the cartoon pictures or any of the rhymes and all, whatever language they see, that language only they will get adapted. So right from now, I am not talking about early childhood care and education. Actually, that is already there. But now, as per the statement of teaching philosophy, teacher's autonomy, teacher enrichment, teacher training, making teacher resourceful. See, your subject, I may not be able to induct in your mind. I may not be able to refresh your mind. But only thing I can do as an academic leader, that I can motivate you, I can inspire you, I can request you. You realize the importance of yourself. You know very well, Chhatrapati Shivaji, if you go to Maharashtra, in everybody house, you see a poster that is a gate kring Chhatrapati Shivaji. Why? They consider it an effective and efficient leader. How Chhatrapati Shivaji has become very popular? Because his mother, Mother Jijiabai, has made him a popular leader. The patriotism and the commitment to duty and working for the country and this Marathas and my development of Maharashtra state, welfare of the Maharashtra people, all these things are inducted in his blood. So this is where, so that is charismatic leadership. So we want such type of effective leaders who can transform the child's mind. It is just like a clay modeling, the raw material. I know the difficulties of Kendriya Vidyalaya teachers. RT is there, BPL is there, EW is there, migrant laborers are there. All children, First generation, those who are not knowing basic things, all this, you have a heterogeneous group of children. First of all, the teachers are first and standard, second standard. It is very difficult for you to control the classroom itself. But if you know how to engage the children, and see, just like in chemical reactions, the nucleus is the center of attraction. So a teacher should be a center of attraction. The way you are wearing clothes, I sincerely appeal to you is your physical appearance as a teacher will take a long way to make an inspired teaching learning. And your smiling face, you may be having hundreds of problems, but our bread earning is this job. And I did my MSc from Indian Institute of Technology, but I like in school education out of my own interest. My age is 59. And I will tell you all of you, next year, May 22, I will retire. But even if I retire, my association with the children, my association with the academic teaching leadership will continue forever as long as I am healthy. Another thing, the program of gifted children, we are already having in Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan. They say that number of courses should be started in B.Ed. programs also. And another thing, 4 years B.Ed., there are so many things which government will do. What, as a teacher, you have to teach, whatever subject you are teaching, that the children should attain minimum levels of learning, and the subject in, see, up to class 3 or 4, I can say it is only English, Hindi and mathematics. EVS is nothing but almost English only. EVS and English. And another thing, most of the teachers, they say, spelling is not so important. Everything is important. See, the first generation child, whose father is a drunkard or whose father is a fisherman. So there you may be giving marks, but always you have to attain perfection and you have to continuously struggle. And another thing, while checking your notebooks, while drawing your figures, and another thing, please encourage questions from children and make live interaction. See, the class should not be dominated by only limited children. And as a teacher, you should have a personal satisfaction. As far as the mathematics is concerned, please use blackboard. Do the number of problems. Ask questions. When I went for inspection, we have a school, KV Karanja, in Mumbai. It is located just like an island. So we have to go by boat or ship like that. I was asking a question to a student. The student stood up and told me, "Sir, in my lifetime, you are the first person to ask me a question." That means it is a failure of our teachers. How can a student ask me? You are a first person to ask me a question. So my dear teachers, so you have a greater responsibility to shoulder all children. And another thing, when your principal comes, don't tell, "Sir, this child is not studying," in front of everybody. I can also say that you are not presenting this program. See, my idea is today you might not have presented, but you have an innumerable number of skills. You have a commitment. You have a devotion. You have a lot of energy. You are physically healthy. When you are physically healthy, also when you are become mentally healthy, you have to make yourself happy. How you will make yourself happy? You should have an objective. You should have a goal. So the main concern is teacher enrichment program, teacher readiness program. The teacher has to willingly, he has to understand what type of children I am teaching. And before, and another thing, now in the month of April, when you are teaching, make a bridge course. See, suppose third stand children, third A children came to fourth A. You became fourth A class teacher. Third class children, whether they achieved in your subject what you are teaching. Once my second daughter was studying, she was studying class 6. I do not have a science teacher. I asked one of the primary teacher to teach. The primary teacher told me, "Sir, your second daughter is very poor in English and she student do not know spellings." Then what I was doing, whenever I have leisure time, I used to go to class and I used to ask my lamps, that means librarian, art teacher, suitable teacher, during their leisure time, they have to conduct a spelling test, reading, make the child stand and read the passage. See, when you go to a doctor, he will do a number of tests. It may be urine test, it may be blood test, it may be X-ray, it may be TMT. So every child is different, and don't think that they are not having talents. Now, talent is not simply mugging in the examination and getting marks. And you see, this coaching, actually the national education policy clearly says the education system. Now we are starting examination in 3rd, 5th, 8th to achieve the this thing, and 10th and 12th examination also. Now the current year, 20% CCT questions in class 10th, 10% in class 12th, and slowly it will increase. Now you know, most of you math, science and English teachers, and some of you are mentors and nodal officers. See, in the field of education, you pay actually grass, you are the field workers. You have seen the picture Bahubali. In the Bahubali, actually who fights in the field? It is a soldier. You are the soldiers of Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan. Now, see, we have number of vacancies. Many people are retiring. But the country is having alarming situation with COVID. In this current scenario, we are not able to conduct interviews. We are not able to conduct written tests. So the country is facing so many problems. Why the academic alternate academic calendar have been introduced? There are some parents who are educated during the lockdown or some other time, because they at least up to class 8. Because each the educated parents at least they can teach up to class 9 or 10 or this thing. That is why this alternate academic calendar has been made. Diksha portal has been started. And all of you are asked to do NISTA training. And you have been asked to undergo this competency-based training by CBSE. And you have been asked to undergo the experiential learning. So experience learning means not touching live wire. This is not experience learning. Because though everybody, but for cutting jokes, don't misinterpret. So there are so many education situations in the country. For the development of the country, for the development of education, for achieving learning, to make the society more effective. See, here in Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan, it is a mini India. Here we know we don't have any caste, creed, color, and other things. It is a wonderful organization. See, any organization will become wonderful, provided inside the members, the teaching principal, AC, DC, they will play their important role. So, my dear friends, so like this, there are a number of things in new education policy. I sincerely suggest all of you, please download the new education policy document. It is there in the NCRT. There is 30 pages on school education. The first one is early childhood care and education. And in our Karnataka, aspirational districts are, one is Raichuru, another is Hatti, and we are trying to open a school at Yadgir also. We are the land and building, they are trying. So these are the two backward districts, that is aspirational districts. So first, one-year pre-primary. Actually, in the budget also, you can see 5.1%, 5.14% budget allocation is there for the development of education. Some of the Kendriya Vidyalayas will be developed as model schools, and some of the teachers will be identified based on the performance as mentors. But all of you are competent, only your willingness to perform, your interest to perform, do not fight each other. And there should be a healthy family way in every school. All of you, in such a critical situation, we are all working. Here, unity is required, and thinking about others, concern for others, universal brotherhood. And most important thing is the six devils are there. All the six devil qualities, please remove from your mind. And think for the welfare of yourself, your neighbor, your own staff, and your children. And please think about the parents. They are illiterate, uneducated, and their children. And initially, when we conduct online mapping data, in the month of April, 1,200 children we are not able to connect. Afterwards, with the help of the teachers, principals, because some of the corporate societies, they have donated mobile phones. And some of the schools, the children were attached to second-hand mobile phones. And some children were given by setting the timetable also. And now, actually, the maximum work has been done at the school level by the principals and teachers. I really appreciate for the efforts made by you. Please continue and take care of your health. And the main thing, the statement of teaching philosophy, it is teacher's autonomy and the methods you are following. Sir, my method is actually many of the classes, when we observe, we are not able to find out interest in our teaching, and only the bright children are answering, and children are not able to reach. And actually, how much content they have learned is not important. The content should be, because operation success, patient died, after studying certain things, and what are the levels he has achieved. And now as a skill, in class 8, we have started 12 hours program, artificial intelligence, and we have started awakened citizen program for the development of value education. And for the grown-up girls, adults, we have started an adolescence educational program. And we have started an old book for a program also. Previous, continuously doing research in the field of education. And all of you are contributing. So all of you, please get motivated. Think in a healthy way. And please keep your head and heart very clean and healthy. Having friendship, mutual understanding. I remember in a national alignment movement, when Mr. Jawaharlal Nehru was the Prime Minister, he started Panchasila. So such a great people, so many great things they brought. You know, please read the this is Gautam Buddha, Mahavir Jain, Chanakya. There are many, book reading is very, very important. The class library, which is there in primary classes, and librarians also conducting general knowledge kits, reading abilities, writing abilities, all these things you have to develop in the children. At the end of the thing, that I have done something for you. See, this is here, whatever you are doing and how much profit. You see, I am a math teacher. I know what is profit and loss. I know whatever I have to do, I have done it. You can ask my colleague, Mr. Raju also. Whatever, see, anything if I takes up, irrespective of this, whether I will get a profit or not, I will do it. Because jina hai to share jaise jina hai. You should work for your identity. And the parents who have given birth to you, and the children to whom you have given birth, you have to give a lot of respect. And you have to bring a very good name for your Vidyalaya. Bharat ka sarnam gauram kendri vidyalaya laayega takshashila nalanda ka itihas lautikar aayega. And every day morning, India is my country, all my brothers are simply like a changing a horse, children are telling. No, whatever that words are there, it should be implemented and they should be melted in our blood. It should be inducted in our mind and we have to go ahead. With this, I will take permission from Raju sir. I will stop from here. I hope I have done something for the betterment of the Bangalore region. I am very extremely thankful to all of you for giving this opportunity. Whenever these type of things are there, actually I wrote in a book and the book was kept somewhere. So I couldn't understand. But actually by reading, it has been recorded in the mind. So whatever, by intuition, whatever is there in the mind, I spoke to you. If at all, if I did a justice, that I could able to inspire you and motivate you, guide you in effectively and in efficient way, I convey my sincere thanks to whole team, Bhanumashri Madam. And now I am eagerly waiting to listen my Shishya. And now my Shishya will act as my guru now for giving statement of teaching philosophy. Mr. Srinivas, Srinivasan, he is M. Srinivasan. He went to Malaysia also. He's a very talented man. His subject is maths. My subject is also maths. He was my PGT and we worked together in Mumbai. And now again, we are meeting in this Google Meet. Once again, I convey my sincere thanks to all of you. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. Really, it is a wonderful keynote address you have given. And what we have to follow as teachers, you have clearly given a guidance to all of us, because we know very well as teachers we can bring lots of changes in the society because we are dealing with the children. As sir says, I 100% agree that quality of education lies with the teachers' quality, and our teachers are also not lesser than anybody. So when they have attended this, because the philosophy of teaching is the methodology or pedagogy what we would like to implement in our classrooms. And with this, sir, I think on behalf of the participant, I assure you, sir, KVS Bengaluru region will do well, and our children also will be taken care, because I understand as a principal, I'm observing their classes every day. We understand the difficulties the teachers are facing with the parents and the principal or whatever may be. And their network connection, now you can see so many people are leaving and coming in because of network problems. Still, they are all striving very hard to reach the children. And I think kudos to all the teachers. And at the outset, I would like to thank Raju sir for giving me this opportunity to coordinate these programs, sir, because I was not knowing what is this philosophy of teaching. So thank you very much, sir. I'll be there with the participants for the whole day, and I'll also gain knowledge, and I will try to implement in my school first, and also we can try in our region. With your permission, I would like to tell the participants that we can break for a tea, and we will be reaching, we will be returning back by 11 o'clock. Please don't log out. You just
madam, 1 minute, madam.